Hello, SPS families, teachers, and staff. As we enter the final weeks of what has been a school year without equal, I want to take a moment to say thank you. From an all-virtual start to our safe and methodical return to in-person instruction, a lot has happened over the past 10 months, including our operations levy, upcoming boundary changes, the siting of a new stadium, and what to name our new schools. Each of these issues has been challenging, and all have prompted spirited conversations across our city. But the extraordinary level of engagement from you, the SPS community, allowed our administration, advisory groups, and school board to make decisions in pursuit of making our district better. And for those of you who may have disagreed with a district decision this year, I ask you to keep engaging with us. If we're going to keep improving, we need to hear from as many different voices as possible. This year has taught us to adapt, to innovate, and to collaborate in the face of a lot of big changes. We overcame some really hard things together, and we're stronger now than we were last fall. I believe the confidence, collaboration, and learning we've experienced is going to launch us into a very successful 21-22 school year and beyond. Right now, we're working on a reopening plan that revolves around five core strategies to put student success and safety first and address the academic and wellness impacts of the pandemic. For starters, SPS is working to establish historically low class sizes at all grade levels. This holds the potential to have a transformational impact on our district for years to come. Students thrive both academically and emotionally when they get more individual attention and support from their teachers. Smaller class sizes will also allow students more personal space in the classroom, keeping them safe and healthy as we ensure compliance with safety guidelines. Providing lower class sizes aligns with long-range planning and reflects the current work being done to provide classroom space by building new schools and adjusting boundaries. Our second core strategy involves adding counselors, mental health therapists, support specialists, and intervention teachers to help students process what they have been through and are still experiencing as we emerge from the pandemic. We encourage all of our students to use these services, whether it's a therapist, a close friend, or a journal. Having a sounding board is an important first step to feeling mentally and emotionally better. And staff as well. If you're interested in speaking with a licensed mental health expert, our school therapists can help point you in the right direction. In the next strategy, we're continuing to invest in social-emotional learning curriculum and training. Even in the best of times, we all benefit from focusing on wellness, developing healthy relationships, resolving conflict, and fostering an inclusive and positive community. Our students in grades K through 12 will engage in lessons that focus on their social-emotional development as we work together to build great school environments that prepare them for success in the future. In our fourth strategy, as we develop staff and teacher trainings, we'll emphasize planning learning experiences that meet the wide range of academic levels and needs in our classrooms. The goal is to use a variety of teaching methods to remove learning barriers and give all students equitable opportunities for success. Our teachers work extremely hard to serve all students, and this training focus is intended to give them options they can adapt to each student's strengths and areas of growth. And the final strategy is to provide additional resources to students most in need. This will be a top priority. Schools will receive extra staffing for intervention supports based on factors like overall number of students, the level of poverty in each school, and how many students receive special education services. This will be added support above what the schools already receive. We have so much to look forward to, and I can't wait to see what our students and staff accomplish next school year. Thank you for continuing to show patience, grace, and understanding during this difficult school year. Your collaboration has proven why Spokane is such a remarkable place to raise our kids. There's so much for us to be proud of, and so many opportunities for us to learn and grow from these experiences. I wish you well in the days ahead as we finish the last few days of school, and I hope that you have a great summer break, and we look forward to seeing you in the fall. Take care.